data from it. Well, this work is it's about a methodological proposal for developing adaptive systems. Well, our experience is based on a real MOOC with this teaching staff and this organization staff. And the idea of the presentation goal is trying to present an instructional design of a MOOC that integrates the advantage of both CMOOCs and HMOOCs, transform the MOOC's weaknesses in strengths using input condition, and improve the MOOC's efficiency, just in order to not to try to enter in the, I don't know, uncomfortable discussions about if MOOCs are good or MOOCs are bad. We are going to try only to use this trend as another possibility, as a new possibility, and perhaps the overall idea is that data MOOC is not good, is not bad, it's only a possibility that is interesting in the strategy, or is clear and useful. Well, we have, as you know, two kinds of MOOCs, SMOOCs and CMOOCs. CMOOCs are the original concept of the MOOCs, based on the collective means idea, is based on social networks and personal environments. They are based on interaction between among persons. And the idea is that the knowledge is created in the personal environments and the social networks. On the other hand, perhaps the MOOC concept is a trending topic since the SMOOC movement appears with courses with a lot of students engaged in that. They are so the strategies mainly conductive. They are similar to a typical online course delivering in a platform. The learning is based on content and tasks, and perhaps the evaluation is about tests, coursework, and sometimes it sounds like a big evaluation. Well, both has advantages, both has weaknesses. Perhaps if we think in the more positive points, XMOOC are better for the student because have a structure, then they get lost less than in a CMOOC that is completely unstructured of links, ideas, something like that. Then we have a content-guided learning comparing with a learning based on a community, and learning is more or less in the sight of the student. The idea is trying to integrate the both sides or the both types of MOOCs just in order to take the advantage we have in the MOOCs types. Then, then we want to have this cooperative idea, the concept guide, the personalized application, the structure, the learning communities, the cooperative knowledge creation, the continuity after the course ends. It means we want all. Thus, we use this real MOOC about open software and open knowledge that was deployed in a Spanish platform for books called Miliada. It was deployed during March and April of this year, and we have more or less 4,000 enrolled students. With serial data, with country, radio, profession, sales, etc. And the main idea is with 4,000 students, we have a heterogeneous score. In the reason that they use or they decide to enroll in the MOOC, also in the education level, also in the age. We have a student between 17 and 65 years. Then, with this scope, we have to try to adapt the contents and adapt our methodology, just in order to try to satisfy the different perception, goals, and expectations of the different students. Then, to do that, we need a instructional design of this course. With this special design was made taking into account different layers. The first was the technological layers. We have the idea of combining the both technological areas that are related with the MOOCs. A platform, a typical platform, like Moodle, something like that, and a social network. Using a common space for the resources that we want to publish, just in order that the participants make content. The pedagogical layer, the idea is based on the three metaphors. We have the root that is deployed in the platform, like a typical online course. We have the contents, the typical base content. The tank is based on the CMOOC idea. It's based on the social network. And the most interesting idea of this metaphor is trying to achieve that this tree could be offered us the fruits. The fruits are the new resources made by the students with a connectivist idea. Then combine both sides of this one. To do that, we also introduce a new layer, a cooperative one. The idea is we have a first platform with a first set of contents and a first set of teachers. But depending on the expectation of our students, we introduce more stakeholders, external entities, and not participants. For example, enterprises that work on open source. More expert that introduce diagonals depending on the idea or depending on the expectation of the students. On the other hand, also we have the social network and the cooperative element for the participants. Trying to move out the typical platform, this kind of interactions. Then, with this approach, we have interesting results. I only present some ideas in order to go fast. For example, we know that one of the big problems of the MOOC are the dropout rates. Then, if we see the MOOC ended up ranking in this platform in the first edition of the several courses that was deployed, we find that the overall ratio is 13.47. Our ending ratio over the total number of enrolled students was 27.8. A very significant difference. But if we study the ending ratio over the student that really initiated the course, because one thing is to enroll and other thing is to initiate this course, we find that our ending ratio was about 45%. But also, if we study, so the ending ratio over the student that really initiated the formative modules, not the presentation, our ending ratio was 54. That means that we have a very interesting methodology just in order to engage the students that really want or really have interest in the course. Well, there are more data about the evolution of the people. It's easy that more or less the most of the students that goes that start module 2 finish the course. Also, we have several data about a survey around the learning, socialization and cooperation, but I think it's going to conclude, and if you have any question, Angel can answer you. I think that with this approach, the effectiveness of the MOOC has been improved. Because we take into account the different profiles to enrich both the resources and the learning. Now, the social network, the social community that starts with this course is still alive. And with more people that in the beginning of this. And also the resources were extended with the resources that were made in the course. And these resources also were organized just in order to improve and extend the knowledge database of the. Thank you.